CFAX Victoria.
An iHeart radio station.
If it's happening, it's here. CFAX 1070.
Good morning. It's 8 o'clock in Victoria, Thursday, May the 13th. I'm Al Farabee. We have sunny skies in Victoria today. Downtown right now, it is 9 degrees. And CFAX 1070 News begins. Here is James Gardner.
Thank you, Al. Good morning, everyone. A new report from the Canadian Civil Liberties Association says provinces became more punitive in their approach to policing COVID-19 infractions. During the second wave of the pandemic, the organization obtained data documenting the number of tickets issued for alleged violations of Manitoba, Ontario, and Quebec increased from the first wave to the second wave of the pandemic. An independent review panel commissioned by the World Health Organization says the coronavirus pandemic was preventable. In a report, the panel found weak links at every point in the chain and said most nations weren't prepared for the public health disaster that was about to unfold. Former New Zealand Prime Minister Helen Clark chaired the panel and called February of 2020 a month of lost opportunity as too many countries waited to see what would happen. The panel is calling for world leaders to create pandemic preparations and for the WHO to have more power to act. Canada's offering help to obtain permanent resident status to the families of victims of two air disasters with strong links to Canada. Federal Immigration Minister, Marco Mendocino, told an Ottawa news conference the offer will be in place for 1 year.
Today's announcement provides a pathway to permanent residency to a group of people whose loved ones made this great country their home before being so suddenly and cruelly taken.
Mendocino says the offer is a show of solidarity with the families of the victims of the Ethiopian